Thank you. The first piece tonight is a little different than you might be used to. For one thing, it's probably the only vibraphone and viola piece you're going to hear all day. And for another thing, it's written by a composer who is still alive. And there's something nice about playing a piece by a living composer, which is we came up with some questions on some notes, and I was able to email David Colson, and a couple days later I got a response. And we tried that with Brahms, and I'm still waiting for that response. When I first knew David Colson, he was the chairman of the music department at Cal State Chico, and he also conducted the orchestra and taught theory and composition and maybe tuned the pianos for all I know. And now he's the chairman of music at Western Michigan University. And he said these things about this piece. Quiet Places consists of four miniatures describing either physical or psychological landscapes. The first two movements are remembrances of fond places. On Deer Creek is a place I frequently went in Northern California for some trout fishing. The water is crystal clear and usually very cold. It flows quickly in the spring and tastes as good as anything. And then the last movement, he said, was inspired by watching, quote, my three-year-old son sleeping late one night. For parents who have babies and young children that are good sleepers, you know what I mean when I say that he provided a good inspiration to finishing a piece of music in a content manner. Both the viola and vibraphone have timbres well suited to such a feeling. So now we'll play Quiet Places by David Colson.
Thank you. So before we begin, just thought I should say a quick word about this piece. It might seem a little peculiar instrumentation here with one viola, two violins, another viola, and a cello. Well, it turns out, for those of you who know this piece by Brahms, it's most commonly known as the clarinet quintet. And seeing as I really don't play a good clarinet, I thought I should try it on the viola. It actually turns out Brahms wrote a viola part for this piece to be played in case the violist decided that they would like to play this piece instead of rather than a clarinet. And it's very rarely performed this way, and we had a great time putting this together, and I hope you will enjoy it as well.
Thank you. Thank you.